at the Victoria Motorcycle Club property in Victoria. And we are here again for the annual Gas Gas Grind. Or maybe it's just called Grind these days. And we're at the start. We're about to have the riders meeting. And first thing we have to do is go around the enduro course, which is comprised of a bunch of logs and rocks and jumps and all sorts of fun to wear us down, which it definitely does. Perfect day for it, beginning of October, and yeah, it's gonna be good.
Same format as last year. If you're not here, you line up behind the log. Engines running. Hands on the head, and we'll start you. You go straight off the log and start following your arrows around the course. A's are running first. It's a 2.5 hour cutoff. B's in the afternoon, it'll be a 1.5 hour cutoff. Senior X is 1.5 hour. Okay, class lineups. Running masters first, then expert, vet expert, senior expert, intermediate. I'll hold the signs up. So position yourselves here so that you can get behind the log and get yourself ready. You got 1 minute between classes.
All right, we got the start of the master. And they're up. Just the three of them in the masters. And 1 minute later, we'll have the experts. Through the nasty rock pit. I tell you, that is energy sapping. Okay, now we've got the experts. I need to wear my glasses just to watch this. Okay, my class is up. Bed expert. One, two, three, four, five of us. So I'm going to start at the back as I did at the last event, just for fun. Well, partly for fun. Partly to keep me from going out too hard, too fast, which I have a bad habit of doing. Plus, I get a good view of what everyone's doing. So, obstacles on this course. This is a nasty one. Where you can get stuff blown at you. Alright. Oh yeah. Well, didn't think I'd be passing guys quite so quickly, but this shows how tough that enduro course is. So I think I'm in third now, behind Simon. Thank you. in no rush, so I'm just gonna pace myself here. So good. You can hear fourth place right behind me. This event really showcases the Victoria Motorcycle Club property, because we're going to circumnavigate it, twist and turn our way through it. I think it's about 300 acres, but they probably managed to squeeze at least a 10 kilometer loop out of here. So now I'm still in third, but first and second have changed places. Simon's on a bit of a tear. Bike getting kicked around pretty good on the fast stuff there. Definitely feels more at home in this stuff. Tight twisty stuff through the trees. Or rocks and logs like those ones. Even though it's rained lately, there is really dry dirt, just half an inch down. So it might even get dusty later on. So far the traction's really good. No dust to worry about. No mud to worry about so far. I doubt if we'll see much mud, maybe a little bit. This is the kind of stuff that gives you arm pump. Starting to get it already. It just seems like it goes on and on. Okay. I believe that puts me into second. Guy to follow. He's going just the right pace for me. Whew. Whenever you think there might be a bit of a rest section something coming up. It just never materializes. This property is just one trial section straight after another. So at the moment I'm letting Simon do all of the trail blazing. So I don't have to concentrate on looking at the arrows. Heading up to the top of the property. So we've been doing nothing but climbing so far. This property is basically one big mountain. Or at least one face of one mountain. So those of us who live around here and ride the property get a lot of practice going up and down stuff. Down, that means something dangerous. Okay, big drop off. No, it wasn't too bad, but if you weren't expecting it, it could be a bit nasty. So even though I started off in last place, I really didn't expect to be in second place before the end of the first lap. But I'm not complaining. Another bit of a riverbed there. A little easier going down than up, but not much. Third place is right on my tail. No need to get too aggressive at this stage. Way too early to be worrying about what place you're in or who's in front or behind you. It's a 2.5 hour event and we're not even half an hour into it, so. Nicely done, Simon. There are lots of places like that where you can take a really nasty line but save a bunch of time. Making a point of taking all the fun stuff. Alright, now we start our trip back down. So straight down to the left there would have been quicker. But I'm just going to tuck in behind Simon. It's more fun. Stalled my bike. So far there hasn't been a single spot where I can take my hand off the bars, get a drink. Okay, down, down, down. And I think right here, yes, is where I wiped out last year. Right where Simon just about wiped out and gashed my forearm open, requiring 13 stitches. I think that's about the worst thing I've ever done. first time I've ever had stitches, in fact. So I'm going to try not to repeat that. There was another fast line to the right. Uh-oh. Which number three just took, so now I'm relegated to number three. And I can hear number four right behind me. Things can change pretty quickly if you get a little complacent. I'll let this guy. How slippery the roots are there. This back end just slid right out as soon as he put the throttle on. Now we're at the start finish. Okay, first, second, and third, better experts. All right, well, that's kind of fun, duking it out. Still didn't get a chance for a drink. Tiring. Glasses on for that one. Little meteor shower. Up since the last time we came through, and it's going to get worse every lap. Which is fine by me. These trials bikes love the tougher stuff. On the pegs and just keep the momentum going. As soon as you slow down and lose your balance, you expend a lot more energy continuing. Sounds like fourth place is nipping up my heels. I'm hoping those guys are not in my class. that was a mistake. Oh, Russell! Right on. Russell is flying. Just overtook me. I thought I was being smart and taking a fast line there. Oh, I can see Russell's got a problem. His kickstand spring is not attached. And his kickstand is just flapping around. Russell's on a mission. He said he just came out for a ride, but I think he sees the trophy in his eyes. He may well have a good chance in his class. I get, I'm going to try and pass Simon. Whew. Maybe on this next uphill rock climb. It's coming up at the end of this stream bed. Behind Russ again, and he's going a good clip, so hopefully he can drag me up to the other guys. I'll just stay in his draft, let him pick the lines. Certainly not worried about his side stand flying around. It's just making a lot of noise. Sounds worse than it is. Good to see guys tangled up together, but looked like they were okay. Depending on what class they were in, that bodes well for Russell and I. Down we go. This time I'm going to take the A line down. It's definitely faster. Here we go. Ah. Yikes. Faster, but more sketchy. meeting just yet. Still not even halfway through the event. Someone here. Seeing as I'm first in my class at the moment, I don't need to worry about him. But it'll be fun to ride with someone. Probably be worried when he hears my engine that it's someone in his class. Little does he know, he doesn't need to worry. That's okay, sometimes you need the push to keep the adrenaline going and keep yourself focused. Having him in front of me than behind me. Sections of the route, of the course. Probably can't tell watching, but that was a pretty steep downhill. And into the start finish one more time. Let's see what this guy. This guy's an expert. He's a fourth place expert. And I'm still in first. If I can maintain this scenario, it's going to be just awesome. It's a pretty good spectator one because of this enduro course. In my class, dicing with a couple of guys. Perfect conditions. Bike is running superb. I'm not feeling too bad so far. Oh, it's always the last hour that counts. Body weight. Same thing again. Oh, sorry, man. Oh, hang on. Yeah, or up. There we go. Okay. Wow. Right on. Not often I get tangled up with someone. My class. So that puts me back in second. Dicing it out. The guy at the front probably having to assume that we're in his class, so he's giving her pretty good. The guy in front is the leader of my class, and he knows that I'm right behind him, so he's not about to let off. A fun ride. Keeps the focus on, that's for sure. Now, let's see what fun we have here. Oh yeah. Nice. Woo! Down again. Woo. All right. Okay, let's see if I can catch this A line down now. Here we go. Oh, that has got a hit to it. At the bottom. Oh. Should still be in first place. Woo. Thank you. And I am. But only just. My friends are right on my heels. And there they are. Woo! Yes! It's the first time I've cleaned that one. Woo! Oh, it's still, it's getting sandy and thick. Deep. Shit. Whew. That did not go to plan. Go little thing like that and lose two places straight away. Now someone else is coming up on my heels. And I've got nothing in the tank to fend him off. All I can do is keep up with this guy. I think it might be Quinn. If so, he's lapping us. That's unbelievable. Oh. Can't even begin to keep up with him. Back brake is gone again. What the hell? Damn it. Come on. Shit. Fuck. Fuck. God damn it. Man, I was lucky there. No back brake, front brake locking up. Definitely going around that hill next time. Okay, strangely enough, the back brake has come back again. I don't get it. Energy to catch up. There's the guy in first, half a lap ahead on enduro cross. No, I've got no back brake again, so this is gonna be persistent issue. So unfortunately I'm gonna have to baby it.
This is the first obstacle on the enduro cross section. Not so easy. Man, a nasty log to get over on straight out. one of the nastier things. Firewood. Again. Come on, popular just came through.